हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, जय हिंद टू ऑल। दिस इज विवेक श्रीवास्तव सर एंड आई एम हियर विद द सेकंड वीडियो ऑफ दैट वाज रिलेटेड टू दिल्ली। इन द फर्स्ट वीडियो वी हैव सीन अबाउट द ओल्ड दिल्ली, ओके, एंड नाउ आई विल डिस्क्राइब यू द इमर्जेंस ऑफ न्यू दिल्ली। दैट वीडियो रिलेटेड टू क्लास 8 सब्जेक्ट हिस्ट्री। ओके बेटा, विदाउट वेस्टिंग एनी टाइम लेट अस स्टार्ट दैट वीडियो, इमर्जेंस ऑफ न्यू दिल्ली। द सिटी दैट इज नोन एज न्यू दिल्ली टूडे एज प्लान एंड डिजाइन बाय द ब्रिटिश कॉलोनिस्ट। नाउ यू वुड हैव वांट टू नो हाउ शाहजहानाबाद और दिल्ली केम अंडर द ब्रिटिश रूल। दैट वॉज द सिटी कंप्लीटली डेमोलिश्ड टू मेक न्यू सिटी ऑफ दिल्ली। When did the New Delhi emerge as a new city under the British? That are the some questions that we will discuss and understand with this topic. So, in September 1803, the EEIC, it means English East India Company, that gained control over Delhi, and after defeating the forces of Scindia chief of Marathas at this point of time, Calcutta was the capital of company terrorism in India, and Delhi was not among in the most significant administrative and commercial centers. Okay, so it allowed the Mughal emperors to continue living in the palace complex in Red Fort. In the first half of the 19th century, racial differences were not steep in Delhi like the presidency cities. The British, instead of living in separate white towns, resided along with the wealthy Indians in the walled city. They enjoyed Urdu and Persian culture and poetry and took part in the local festivals. In 1792, Delhi College was established, which encouraged intellectual growth in the field of science and humanities, particularly in the field of science and humanities in Urdu language. Due to the great increase in the intellectual activities, the period of 1830 to 1857 is also referred to as a period of the Delhi Renaissance. Okay, it means in that time Delhi changes. दिल्ली का पुनर्जागरण, रेनेसा मीन्स पुनर्जागरण, ओके, सो रीडेवलपमेंट, पुनर्जागरण। सो हाउ दिस फेज डिड नॉट लास्ट फॉर लॉन्ग। रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन द कंपनी एंड द मुगल एम्परर्स इन पार्टिकुलर एंड दिल्ली रेजिडेंट्स इन जनरल टर्न सावर। द एम्परर आफ्टर बीइंग परसुडेड बाय द रिबेल्स एक्सेप्टेड टू देयर लीडर्स। During the 4 month long capture of Delhi, the rebels caused immense harm to the property of the company and also killed several British living in the city. When British recaptured the city, their wrath fell not only on the rebels but also on the innocent people of Delhi. They went on a loot and killing spree. There was total chaos in Delhi, describing with Urdu poet Zahir Dehlvi, and who was an eyewitness of the events of 1857 in Delhi, wrote that residents fled from the three gates of the walled city to find refuge wherever they could. These lines of his pen and violence inflicted on the Delhi residents, that is a Urdu poem, like हर एक शहर का पीर वो जहाँ कति हुआ, हर एक कबीला व हर खादून कति हुआ, हर एक अल ए जहान खुश बयान कत्ल हुआ, गर्ज खुशाला ये है एक जहां कत्ल हुआ, दैट इज अ उर्दू पोयम एंड ऑल द इट मीन्स ऑल द यंग ऑफ द ओल्ड सिटी वेयर मेट्राइड एवरी ट्राइब्स एवरी फैमिली वाज मेट्राइड एवरी एक्सप्रेसिव स्वीट टंग स्पीकर वाज मेट्राइड इन शॉर्ट एन एंटायर वर्ल्ड वाज मेट्राइड इट मीन्स द सेंस ऑफ दीज लाइन्स दैट इज ऑल द एंटायर वर्ल्ड वाज मेट्राइड सो सिंस द रेबल्स रोज अंडर द बैनर ऑफ एम्परर बहादुर शाह जफर ही वाज सीन एज अ थ्रीट फॉर द इनवोकिंग अपराइजिंग इन द फ्यूचर ही वाज देयरफॉर एक्साइल्ड टू बर्मा नाउ दैट इज नोन एज म्यांमार ब्रिटिश वांटेड टू दिल्ली टू फॉरगेट द ग्लोरियस पास्ट अंडर द मुगल्स सो सेवरल प्लेसेज ऑफ मुगल एम्परर इंक्लूडिंग हिज कोर्ट वाज डेमोलिश्ड एंड बैरक्स वेयर बिल्ट इन प्लेस ऑफ गार्डन गार्डन्स पवेलियन ऑफ मशिक इन द एरिया अराउंड द रेड फोर्ट वेयर डेमोलाइज्ड फॉर द सिक्योरिटी रीजन हाउएवर द टेम्पल्स वेयर नॉट रिमूव्ड एज दे वेयर नॉट सीन एज सिक्योरिटी कंसर्न बाय द ब्रिटिश मेनी मस्क्यूवर्स वेयर कन्वर्टेड इन टू बिल्डिंग्स विद अदर यूजेस लाइक जिंताल मस्जिद दैट वॉज टर्न इन टू अ बेकरी British put up a ban of 5 years on worshipping in the Jama Masjid, the canal of Shahjahanabad were filled up and eventually 1/3 of the city was destroyed. After the destruction of the city began the phase of its expansion. In the 1870s, the western wall of Shahjahanabad was broken down to build the railway. Okay, the British shifted from World City and began living in a new secure area in north of the city away from the Indian population. The Delhi College was converted into a school and later closed down in 1877. During the uprising of 1857, the British released the people of India considered the Mughal Emperor as a leader and Delhi as a seat of Mughal power. So they decided to undermine these sentiments of Indians by organizing in the city some grand events of demonstrate of British authority over India. First of these events was held in 1877 by Viceroy Lytton to acknowledge Queen Victoria as the Empress of India. Acknowledge it is worth noting that at this time Calcutta was the British India. Calcutta was the capital of British India. Then in 1911 another darbar that was held in Delhi to celebrate the coronation of King George V in England. In darbar the British announced their decision to shift the capital of India from Calcutta to Delhi. It means in 1911 the capital was shifted from Calcutta to Delhi by the Britishers. With this begin of making up modern city of New Delhi as we see today, the British hired two architects, Edward Lutyens and Herbert Baker, to design New Delhi and its buildings. An area of 10 square mile was chosen for Raisena Hill, which was located to the south of Shahjahanabad. New Delhi was laid out in a geometric pattern over a triangular based form of Connaught Place, which was the commercial center of the city, the government complex and the India Gate that had the statue of King George V. Which has now been removed. The government complex consisted of Viceroy's Palace, now Rashtrapati Bhavan, we know as Rashtrapati Bhavan today, that was at that time a Viceroy Palace, and twin secretariat buildings built on the either side of a 2-mile long road known as Kingsay, now Rajpath, एंड दिस इम्प्रेसिव स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द ब्रिटिश राज वर बिल्ट ऑन द एलिवेटेड रायसेना हिल टू मेक दिस इजिली विजिबल टू द नेटिव्स एंड रिमाइंड देम द ब्रिटिश अथॉरिटी एवरी डे. दिस बिल्डिंग वेयर constructed in a new style of architecture which was a blend of the classical Greek and the Mughal and the Buddhist architecture elements like the use of red sandstone, jalis and chhaja, chhatris, carved brackets and elephant heart on the pillar capitals. The architecture wanted New Delhi to represent a scene of law and order that would not be chaotic and old Delhi. So they built broad straight streets in New Delhi with spacious bungalows on its sides. The city had plenty of trees and several parks that provided fresh air. This was in sharp construct to crowded mohallas and narrow winding streets of old Delhi. It is a clean and healthy space with better water supply, sewage disposal and drainage facility than old Delhi, reminding the architecture of the purpose for the constructing of new city. It is not a cantonment we have to lay out at Delhi, but an imperial city, the symbol of British Raj in India. In 1931, New Delhi was finally inaugurated as the capital of undivided India. So students, that is all for today's video. And in the next video, I will describe you the fate of old Delhi. Okay, that will be the last video of this chapter. Till then, have a nice day. Thanks for watching.